Fuckcast.
23 Fuckcast.
I'm excited.
I'm jazzed as shit right now.
I know you're jazzed.
We just played a good song. I'm ready to go. I'm going to punch a hole in the wall if we don't do this Fuckcast. Like, all right. Let's fucking do it. First topic.
All right. First topic. Super Bowl.
Super Bowl.
It was, Sunday, right? Super Bowl Sunday.
Are you serious?
Okay, so, ladies and gentlemen, you have a person here who knows almost absolutely nothing about football, and you have a guy who's like, fucking fantasy football league.
Yeah, I won my fantasy football league.
You know the players' hometowns and shit?
I'm not even joking. I won my fantasy football league. I know everything. Super Bowl should be fucking a holiday.
If you were to get a grade in Super Bowl class, you'd get an A+.
I don't know if I could get that plus.
Would you be the teacher's
pet? I'd
be
an A student. I can't dedicate my life to football like some A+ students.
Some people do, man. I work at the place I work at. Everybody else is all about Super Bowl and football. Yeah. And I am I'm not ignorant. I know what football
is.
I've watched games before.
Because I got smashed, man. I couldn't walk at the end of the night.
I actually volunteered to work that day because I had nothing to do and I didn't have any interest.
Yeah, but everyone likes you then because everyone's trying to get off work and you're the guy who's he took my Super Bowl day.
Oh, man, I got to work. It's a Super Bowl.
You know what you're missing out on? This is what you're missing out on. I bet you're not taking advantage of this, is that you could get some stuff out of people. Like, they want Super Bowl free. So you could be like, hey, man, it's going to cost you $100.
Like, if I was Jewish, I'd be like, Christmas, I'll work your Christmas shift for you.
But no, don't just say you'll work Christmas shift. I'm saying you could get something out of it. Like, you're giving up your...
Yeah, you've got to give me, $50 or something that. Or
you need to hold out, is what I'm saying.
Give me, an iTunes card, gift card or something, or Starbucks.
Yeah. You really don't give a fuck. I'm saying you would take it for free because you don't care, so you want to work.
Yeah, but I might as well get something out of it.
You might as well, take advantage of this situation.
Yeah. So what sports teams were playing this year at the Super Bowl?
The Ravens and the 49ers.
Okay, where are the Ravens from?
Baltimore.
Where are the 49ers from?
Are you fucking with me right now? Or is this for real?
I obviously know it's the San Francisco 49ers.
I usually have a great gauge of whether you're joking or not, and I think that's what makes our humor work. But right now, right there,
So you're kind of baffled on whether I actually know stuff about Super Bowl or football
or
not?
I agree with you, or I know that you don't give a shit about it that much, but the level of not give a shit that you just displayed to me as far as not knowing the teams or where they're from is... That's what's mind-blowing.
Do you think everybody that listens to the Fuckcast is an avid Super Bowl fan, football and stuff? Like, they watch the Super Bowl?
The real answer, probably not. There's some people like you.
So there's probably some people that are going to be behind me. There's some Team Evan people out there.
Team Evan. You think there's going to be some fucking people, I bet non-Americans, if we have a non-American listening to it, they don't give a shit about
the Super Bowl. Yeah, if you're listening to this from, fucking Budapest.
Team Evan is all foreign, everybody.
Chile? Chile people, they love us.
Chile?
We're on a Chilean.
Is it Chile or Chile?
We're a Chilean. Think about this, dude. What if people put the Fuckcast in Chilean, radio stations? You know, if you're in fucking Chile, driving to work in the morning, and it's oh hey, it's a Fuckcast.
Oh, there's a Chilean version of you and
me. Yeah, we ever travel to Chile, we'd be hey, holy shit, that's McGann Evan. You guys are we're big fans of your show, and we're like, what the fuck are you talking about? You've been big in Chile for a long time.
Maybe there's a lot of Team Evan, because there's a lot of fucking Chilean people listening to this now.
Man, I fucking love my Chileans.
Can we look up our fucking demographic or where everyone comes from?
Oh, yeah, that'd be great. If we had a map of the United States for each, podcast listener episode, we could, little pinpoint, fucking Iceland is joining in today.
Oh, it's just, a progress map of the new places we've
connected
with?
Yeah, to-go bag, we have our materials, and one of them is a map of the United States and where all you unique listeners are from.
You think we're gonna have fucking to-go bags and shit like that?
I'm thinking our emergency Fuckcast briefcase that we had that we carry around handcuffed to ourselves.
Oh, okay, I know.
Whenever we do a Fuckcast,
we have a
small duffel bag that we keep all of our shit in. We're trying to expand it into a classy thing, so we just walk into a room, boom, Fuckcast is happening right now.
Call that spontaneous cast.
Bring me my fucking hot wings. We're doing it at Hooters.
Are we walking down the street and I'm like, we're just hanging out. We're not planning to do a Fuckcast, but I'm like, dude, Fuckcast right now. Let's get down. You're like, what? I'm not ready. And we're at Hooters or something. I'm like, dude, we're doing a Fuckcast right now. Bust out the briefcase so we carry it with us at all times.
Yeah, if we're driving down the road and there's a fucking beautiful sunset, we're like, dude, let's Fuckcast about this right now. If it was an app,
did you have to go that?
If it was an app
romantic
on your phone,
why'd you go so romantic on me, man?
I don't know. Sunset. That's driving on the road, listening to some techno music or something.
Here's
like that.
Here's the difference
me and
between you and me, and this describes our Super Bowl differences real well. Is that I said, "Dude, Fuckcast spontaneous in Hooters. You were like, let's spontaneous fuckcast at a sunset.
I said, bring me wings, bitch. I was implying that we were going to Hooters.
Well, that was before we initiated where the fuckcast would be recorded.
I guess so.
I don't know.
All right. So did you win any money on the Super Bowl is what I'm really curious about.
I won $70.
What?
Yeah.
How much did you put in?
12.
Okay. So you beat everybody?
Yeah, fucking, was it $70? Maybe I'm just delusional.
Wait, did you just say, like, one or the other, like, okay, the Ravens are going to win, or did you say, like...
You picked the score
you
at the end of
you
each quarter.
You picked the score?
Yeah, and then I won the score, I thought twice, but maybe once. Like I said, I got pretty smashed, so I was on the floor laying in the kitchen at the end of the night, so
I think there's a picture out there on the internet that exists of you passed out in the kitchen.
Oh, fuck, there is. Someone took a picture of that.
Yes.
Everyone's going to try to look at that now?
Yeah.
Don't look at that.
Yeah,
go look at that. I thought it was safe.
If you're not already friends with McKay, be friends with McKay. Don't just listen to the podcast. Be friends with him.
Be friends with me on Facebook, and you can see me just smashed on the floor.
I think you can see that we're not actors. You know, like, this is real life shit.
We don't pretend to, like, hang out and fucking do shit together. We see sunsets, and we do go to Hooters.
I would say that we're not posers.
We're not posers.
No, no posing.
We could bust out in a fuckcast for real sometime because we hang out.
Yeah, I think so.
This is realistic.
Do you want to hear my crazy football theory for picking teams? Because I get, like I said, all the guys that I work with are all about football, and I told them that I'd join in a couple bets every once in a while, and what I do if I want to pick a winning team...
Oh, my God.
Here's what I do, okay? So I pick the team. So give me like two sports teams, like two football teams.
Okay, the Minnesota Jackrabbits.
Is that a real team? No, like,
yeah, for sure.
The Minnesota Jackrabbits?
Yeah, they're a football team.
The fuck? Like, is it NFL?
Yeah. The Minnesota Jackrabbits, man.
Are you fucking serious?
No.
I thought I knew, like, most of the sports teams, but the Minnesota Jackrabbits does not ring a bell.
Well, you don't pay attention.
Okay, so Minnesota Jackrabbits versus who?
Versus the New Orleans Sea Otters.
You're fucking lying, dude. There's no way it's not the New Orleans Sea.
Why are you're crazy? All right, it's the Minnesota Jackrabbits.
Are you fucking with me right now?
No,
you're fucking with me.
I'm not fucking with you. And the Minnesota Jackrabbits and the New Orleans Sea Otters.
Dude, you're fucking lying right now.
No, dude, go look at like teams move and change names. You're thinking that the old names of the teams are still on them, but like you know,
are you just listing their mascots or is that the actual team name?
That's the team name.
That's not the team name. That's not the New Orleans
Sea Otters. Yeah.
No, it's not. You're fucking lying to me.
Google that shit.
Dude, you are fucking lying to me. And I'm going to Google that shit right now.
Google that shit, bitch.
Isn't it like the New Orleans Saints?
No. That's fucking basketball team.
What?
That's the basketball team. New Orleans Saints is the basketball team. New Orleans Sea Otters is the NFL team.
This is the crazy shit. I'm blowing my own mind right now because that does not like ring any kind of bell.
I don't even know why you're looking it up. Like, I'm the guy who knows about all the football stuff, and you're not. So why are you questioning my judgment right now?
It's the Saints, dude. Fuck you. It's the Saints. You're trying to fucking trick me.
I just thought I did some good acting right there.
Dude, you did some pretty good acting.
I
was trying to make a point. Could you give me two real, like, NFL team names, and I will tell you who's going to win based on my theory.
Why do you need new... Okay, because you're going to go off something on their uniforms.
Yeah.
Okay,
I got something going on.
Okay,
just,
it was the New Orleans Saints versus Minnesota doesn't even have a fucking football team. So, like, the New Orleans Saints versus the Florida Dolphins.
Okay. So, my theory to pick the team would be to say if their mascots were real and fought, who would win?
Okay, so between a Saint and a Dolphin.
Between a Saint and a Dolphin. But you also have to clarify.
Just tell
me. Okay, I'd say the Saints.
The Saint would kill a dolphin.
Be like a human, and they would be like, okay, I need to go fishing or whatever, and they would get a dolphin.
All right.
But there is no way a dolphin would ever kill a human being like a saint.
All right.
And a saint probably wouldn't be swimming in the ocean anyways.
All right, I want a new sample. Okay, Eagles versus the Buffalo Bills.
Okay, well, we got to figure out what a bill is.
Well, Buffalo. That's their mascot. It's a buffalo versus the Eagles.
Is their mascot really a buffalo?
Yeah, it's a buffalo on the helmet.
Okay. Then
now you don't know if I'm fucking with you or
not. Okay, no way an eagle
could kill a buffalo.
Ever kill a buffalo.
It could, like, scratch its eyes out and shit like that. And then it would starve to death, and then eagle wins.
Maybe, but I'm talking about, like, a fight. Like, if you put him in a cage,
right, so you got,
and one
you
of
got
them was going to die.
First you got a saint, and then you got an eagle. So then they go to the championship. Who wins between a saint and an eagle?
Well, again, I don't think an eagle in a cage match
would be able to take out,
because that's
open.
What we're talking about. It's a battle.
Oh, I didn't know you were in a cage. I thought you meant out,
I mean, like
out
I said,
in the wild.
Like I said, a saint is never going to be like swimming in the deep ocean in his fucking monk robes or whatever.
Hunting
I,
a dolphin?
I guess you could
he
be.
He could
like,
be in a boat, dude. That was realistic.
Yeah, is he going to fall off? Is the dolphin going to like stab with his bottlenose?
No, but I didn't know they were in a cage. Is the cage full of water? Because then the saint's going to have some problems.
Oh, the saint drowned right away as the dolphin was doing backflips.
All right, new sample I got. Okay, who would win between a jackrabbit and a sea otter? The Minnesota Jackrabbits versus the New
Orleans
Sea Otters.
I would say if maybe I think it's unfair for either one of them to have the home court advantage. So I'd say you have to be able to put them in an environment where there's zero G's in space. And fight, because if you put a jackrabbit in the water, it's gonna drown. And if you put a sea otter that's only, you know, around water in the desert, they're both gonna die. Home court advantage is unfair.
But you're not a scientist. You don't know if the zero G would give one of these animals an advantage.
Dude, I have a t-shirt right here with a bear versus a shark. It's like a bear fighting a shark.
Yeah, the band.
And it's
right?
one of those things. I love that. No, it's just a funny shirt that I have.
All right. Well,
but it's funny because every time I wear that shirt, people are always like, "Well, that fight could never happen."
Yeah, but your solution to there being no fair battleground is zero G's in space is what solve.
Well, obviously, if a bear was fighting a shark in the water, shark would have an unfair advantage.
Okay.
And if a bear was fighting a shark on the earth, he'd just have to wait 5 minutes for the shark to drown.
So you think an empty chamber?
I'm thinking like a zero G.
Wouldn't that
cage? That
yeah,
you
but
put
the,
him in.
Well, the shark's gonna have a disadvantage in anything but the water. Like, a shark is disadvantaged anywhere.
So
but
you're
water.
Saying that maybe if we give like, because then we're talking about like giving theirs like underwater sea masks and stuff like that. And then we get back to the ridiculousness of it just being in fucking space, anyways.
Giving bears underwater sea masks.
Like, yeah, do you think weird. If okay, so if a bear happened to be walking past an area where there happened to just be enough water. Where, like, it was, near, like, if it was maybe a polar bear, we should use an example. Polar bear migrated south far enough to actually see, like, a shark in the water. And
then they
like,
fought.
No, I'm thinking, like, maybe, like, the shark took, like, one of the bear cubs, you know, from Mama Shark.
Uh-huh.
Out in the wild, you know? Like, if a shark came up out of the water, like, and just ate, like, the fucking baby cub, do you think the bear would be like, I don't care if I have to dive underneath the water and know I'm out of my element, like, I'm gonna kill that shark?
You think
it would dive into the water and
no,
knowing that it would have an unfair advantage?
No, it's out in the wild. They're all survival of the fittest. Like, once your baby's dead, you're like, there's no revenge in the wild. You know what I mean?
You just like, move on and try to, like, find a mate for the next one.
You're like, oh, that baby's gone. Move the fuck on. You don't
try to get animals who have, like, okay, you lay, like, 25 eggs and only four of them hatch. Are you, like, depressed
no,
every
happy.
Single day? Do you start drinking and, like, no, you fucking no. move on, right?
You fucking move on with those four children. And two of them are probably going to die. After they're born. They didn't,
so what if, okay, so what if you were at the zoo and you had a shark tank next to the bear exhibit?
All right, this
power
is good.
Went out, the doors opened and all the cages.
Yeah.
And the bear happened to wander into the shark area.
Okay. By accident.
By accident and got locked in there so he couldn't go anywhere. And let's just say, like, this is over, like, you know, winter break and, like, somewhere where you can't go to the aquarium.
This is an elaborate fucking story. Get to
Anyways,
the point.
So the bear's like, man, I am so hungry. I'm a fucking bear. I usually have people feed me all the time, but the power's out. What are they going to do for food?
And he goes into
and
the shark
And there's a fucking,
cage.
No, there's the only thing there is a shark. How does the bear even get the shark out of the water?
All right, so you're saying if
does he
was
jump
starving and he saw the shark and he knew it could he could eat it, then would he jump in and battle the shark?
I don't know, dude. I mean, I think bears' fishing skills are always overrated. I mean, you pretty much just see bears sitting
overrated.
Like they catch fish in their mouth when the salmon swim upstream. They're fucking tricking the bears into diving into their fucking mouths.
I've never heard bears swimming is overrated in my life before.
No, I'm saying like their fishing skills. I don't think a bear can kill like a regular fish without it just jumping into his mouth to the point where it could.
You have
like a super fish. If a bear could fish for like a super fish, like a fucking shark, I think it would be defeated. I don't know. I think I'm taking back my answer on bear versus shark. I think
you
that
had shark first or you have bear?
No, I guess I was kind of like, you know, it was an unfair advantage, but I would say that a bear has more appendages to like, because if a bear got behind a shark, it can really just flip
it can
around. It really
it,
can't like.
It could fuck it in the ass and the shark's not going to do shit.
Right?
So are bears raping sharks these days is the final question.
Maybe. I don't know. Do sharks have blowholes like dolphins? Because that'd
they got,
be a little bit more
they got
accessible.
A hole. There's got to be a hole somewhere for that shark, for that
right,
bear.
Right, because like sharks take, like they poop in the
yeah,
ocean, right?
So a bear will find that hole and take advantage of it.
Okay. So do you think there's any way a shark, if just like a, if a SeaWorld truck happened to crash, there was a tank carrying a fucking shark, and they were going through Yosemite National Park at the bear exhibit, and the fucking cage cracked or something like that. There was a car accident. A tourist ran into him. The fucking cage cracks.
Dude, you are like an
and
artist.
And the shark, like, is wiggling around the campground. Do you think there's any way a shark would be writhing around on the land looking for air because it's about to die because there's no more water, uh-huh. and sees a shark and go, I'm going to fucking kill that shark or kill the bear. Do you think the shark could ever kill the bear in wild? Without being underwater?
If it's like a great white and just it's flopping around, but it's using those big jaws, fucking could take it out. But it would die in like a minute.
Yeah, right? So.
How long can a shark stay out of water?
I don't know. Like the movie Free Willy, they put him on a flatbed truck and he just kept spraying with squirt guns, right?
But a whale is a mammal. Shit to go through its gills, you know, air to go through its gills. So like technically a shark would only have a minute to battle something?
I don't know. Like, I went fishing with my dad. We used to, you know, bring the fish up on the shore, and, like, they would wiggle around for a while.
The whole point
probably
is
like a good,
is
like, I'd say, like, a good, like, 5 whole minutes for, like, a regular fish, like a trout. So, like, if a shark is, like, a, you know, super fish, it'd probably have, like, you know, 3 hours.
What the fuck are we talking about?
Yeah, like we talked about the Super Bowl, and I talked about my prediction methods. And this is the problem that I get into is that we talk about these crazy scenarios of these animals fighting, and we get fucking lost.
Well, let's go to the second topic.
Do you think we should go to the second
topic? We're so fucking lost. Yeah.
All right, so let's just sum up Super Bowl real quick. You would say that it's Super Bowl is your favorite thing in the world?
No.
Okay, but it's like a pretty fun thing you look forward to.
There's stuff like pussy and weed and stuff like that that comes before Super Bowl.
Art?
Yeah. Oh, photography.
Photography.
Yeah, I guess that's cool.
So yeah, for me, it's like just another day. I don't really pay attention to sports at all. But if I was gonna watch a football game, I would know and understand what's going on. And I actually have been to Super Bowl parties, and I have watched football games. I'm just like, you know, think I don't fucking dwell on it.
Are you trying to save yourself?
Yeah. If any Super Bowl fans try to unfriend me today, please.
Well,
you're
trying to like be more manly, like when.
Dude, no, we're broadening our appeal right now. We're not both like hardcore Super Bowl fans and football fans.
All
right. We're like kind of, you know, on either side. So the Chileans and the Icelandians, you know, they can listen in too.
We're diversifying, but also they say to focus on one group. Otherwise, if you spread yourself thin. Are we spreading ourselves thin?
Like Telemundo doesn't try to go get the black vote, you know.
Yeah, yeah, they don't give a shit. So that leaves us at that.
Well, let's talk about the next topic.
What is the next topic?
Is war.
Why are we talking about war?
Dude, I think everything's pretty tense right now with like North Korea. I think there was a video of them testing rockets and stuff like that. And, you know, just like, you know, that's kind of like the, I'd say if you listed out the number, like the top 10 threats to the United States right now or to like the world, it would be North Korea's on the top of the list. So it gets to that point where we're just waiting for them to pull the trigger on us so we can just go and fucking annihilate them and take, you know, someone out of power and, like, you know, put someone
else
in.
Are you just like, is this recent news or are you just
dealing
with your paranoia?
Like, no, this is like recent news.
No, I know that North Korea is recent news, but when I say recent, I mean like last night or yesterday, did something happen that.
No, I think I saw an article where they were talking about how if North Korea launches like a weapon of mass destruction, you know. I think the rights that we have as like a country or like NATO or whatever is that we have to respond with like a equal. We can't respond with anything more than like an equal retaliation. So if they bomb like Los Angeles, we can't just nuke their entire country. We kind of have to retaliate with sort of equal.
Let me ask you a question, which is you and me have never been in a war. So like, let's say North Korea we go to war.
Dude, I think you and I are like that. I think they'd skip over us because we're entertainers. And I think it's just
I get that kind of war, like a war. But what if they nuked us and we nuked them and we went to like all out war? Like it didn't matter if you were an entertainer or anything. Like what is Evan?
Oh,
Roman
you mean
doing?
Like if there was like North Korean forces occupying like Scottsdale, Arizona right
like,
now?
You have no choice. We're going to war.
All right. So let's just say while we're recording this podcast, there's like sirens blaring outside and there's like North Koreans dropping in off parachutes.
Maybe
and stuff
not
like
even
that.
North Koreans, like aliens. Like we go into Independence Day mode or something.
Oh, dude.
And you got to go to war.
Total war?
Yeah.
Dude, I think I'd be okay at total war. Like I think I'm pretty.
So
like,
I'm asking you, why would you be okay?
I think I, you know.
What the fuck are you doing like in the war?
I actually feel like I have some outdoor survival skills. I used to go hunting and camping. I was a fucking Boy Scout for a little bit.
All
right. I actually I own a couple of guns. which is also a hot topic. But I think that would help me fend off some people that would maybe kill me faster. And I think I wouldn't have a problem taking out an alien race if they were trying to take us out, too. I wouldn't be, like, hiding. I'd be like, all right, well, let's go fucking kill them because they're killing us.
You think we would have a chance against a fucking alien race?
I don't know, man.
That's your...
Is it like Martians coming in on fucking spaceships with ray guns?
But you have that mentality. Like, some people in the alien movies are like, oh, no, we're all going to die. You know what I mean? They freak out. You're the guy who's like, fuck that. I'm going to put
I'm not just going to lay down in my bed and fall asleep and die of old age because they're, you know, taking over and stuff like that. I'm going to get up there and get out and do something, you know?
And do something? So, like, if
you and I are fighting and I'm, like, in a place where, like, I got, like, my leg chopped off and I'm like, okay, go on without me. And you're like, no, Evan, I can't leave you. I'm like, no, I'm going to go. And I, like, open up my vest and I have, like, 10 tons of, like, dynamite. And you're like, oh, okay. He's going to, like, go out with a bang and, like, take out as many of these fuckers as possible, you know?
That's the kind of guy you'd be. You'd just kill yourself for everyone else to save us. If you could stop the ship with, like, exploding your body, but you have to die, like, you would do that? Like Independence Day, right?
Like, if I was beamed up on the alien spaceship and that was like where the queen fucking alien was, and I had like a grenade, and I'm like, okay, well, there's no way I'm getting off this ship, but like, otherwise, if they don't get away, they're gonna like kidnap the president and his wife.
What if the new race, like, they beam you up to the queen, but she's not like an alien?
What if she's like super hot?
Yeah, she's super hot. She's
I'm like, oh, this is pretty cool.
They beamed you up to their new society. It's just all naked hot bitches, but they want to kill. Isn't there a movie like this where?
Oh, so there's like a land of like big titty ladies. Like,
and dude, where's my car? And then all the aliens are hot as fuck.
Oh, did they ever get the choice? Like, hey, you want to, you know, if you do this, like, we'll save your entire planet or something like that, or like a ultimatum? Like, would it be okay if like you got beamed up to the hot big titty alien planet, like, and you're like, okay, we're gonna kill Earth, and you're like, I don't care, I'm in the fucking paradise.
That's the kind of person would you go, no, like, well, it depends what the stipulation is. Like, if they're like, you can't save Earth unless you fuck us all, then you're like, all right, you know, I'll save Earth.
I'll do my best.
I'll try to spare everyone. I don't know if it's gonna work out. I'll try to fuck you all, but it's gonna be rough. Or like, if they're like, oh, you know. I don't know. What would be a bad stipulation?
I think I would try to stop them, you know? Like, if there was a spaceship or whatever, and we were standing at the helm, and they were like, all right, we could fire on Earth in, like, 5 seconds, and I'd, like, take the steering wheel and turn it to the moon or something like that. They're like, no! And, like, take us all out. I think I'd do that. I think that'd be better than, like, okay, cool. Like, I'm glad I didn't live in fucking, like, that place. Like, good for you guys.
I don't
like,
have try enough.
To, like, be all kiss-ass to the aliens. They just killed our whole Earth. Fuck that shit, dude. Fuck that shit.
You're raging too hard right now, right?
Dude, I would crash this into the fucking moon. If aliens open fired on Earth and I was standing on the ship and they were like, okay, well, you can join our team, I'd be like, America! Crashes into the fucking moon.
Why do you have to crash into the moon?
I don't know,
dude. That thing.
I guess if they like shoot Earth and it like fucking explodes, I guess the moon is like the closest place.
You can't just steer it off into space?
Like, you gotta kill the moon? Aim it straight at the sun?
If the moon blew up, Earth would probably be fucked too. Like, what amount of debris would just fall on Earth, like fucking, and destroy all kinds of things?
Oh yeah, just like it breaks into like eighths, and it just the moon just comes down to Earth and just annihilates.
Would it get
continents?
Would it gain enough speed to like from our what's it called?
Dude, I think that with the gravitational pull, if it broke into like smaller
pieces,
would it
be like a meteor?
No, I think it would be like it would take like it'd be like every like each day you wake up, you're like, it got a little bit closer, I think.
Oh, it'd be real slow?
I think it'd be like I think it'd be like super slow. Like, I think
it'd fall
like maybe
a satellite or something like that. Like a giant, like, I don't know.
Like maybe the smaller pieces, but I think like,
dude, we would get big ass pieces, like just from the, depends how.
Well, like, yeah, like the size of a Volkswagen would be like the size of like you know, like a 747, but before it gets into space, it's going to burn up a little bit.
Well,
so like something the size of Texas, by the time it gets down to Earth, it would be like the size of like fucking, I don't know, Arizona.
Okay, but would the laser that you hit it with, would it just like cut it in half?
Whoa, 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 whoa. We have lasers now?
No, you're in that.
Oh, my spaceship. Yeah, okay.
You're in the spaceship with the big tit ladies, right? And they're about to laser beam Earth, and you said you would save us. Does the laser beam do like the Death Star, which just like shatters the moon? Then we're fucked. Or if it just cuts it nicely?
No, the ship is firing on Earth, and I'm stopping them, and I'm driving the ship actually into the moon.
To kill all of you?
To kill all of us so we don't kill Earth.
You couldn't just like steer them away?
I'm saving us. I'm saving us, man.
You could delay it? like,
I don't know,
you
or like keep yourself, or like the guy who has like the joystick, I like knock his hand out of the way and then like start punching everyone.
You want to be
I'm like Captain Kirk. I'm like, oh, you're never gonna do that, and I knock the steering wheel out of the guy's hand, and the steering wheel for the pirate ship like starts spinning, and we start going left,
and then you save the day. Like, there's no way they could steer it back or anything.
No,
like
dude,
that.
they would just like shoot me in the head or with the ray guns, and they would just continue on doing it.
Well, hopefully
you'd have to like pull out a grenade or light a stick of dynamite or something.
Hopefully not. Here's how we all win is that you save Earth, and punishment in their world, since they're all big titted bitches, is like fucking you or something like that. Like,
dude, what if,
the punishment for saving us was like a benefit for you.
Yeah. Like,
like, oh, now you have to come back to our
we
planet.
Sentence him to blowjobs.
Blowjobs. All day blowjobs.
For your crimes against the big titties, ladies.
Could you turn that into like, would that be torture if like you were constantly being blown? Like, not when you enjoy, like, someone
is
sucking
your penis.
It's more like an irritant.
You don't think I'm getting blown.
Your dick would probably come off eventually, right? If someone was blowing you 20, they're like, as punishment, you get blowjobs like constantly forever.
Dude, what if the alien race is like something that's like not hard enough to like, you know, like give you like a rash or like,
their skin.
It's like a species of like ghosts or something like that have like vapor, and it's like the most amazing feeling ever. You're like, oh, this is awesome. That'd be awesome. There's like things like, if we're talking about going to war, like with aliens, like there's probably even like races of aliens that we don't even know anything about. Like, they're just made up of laser beams.
We probably,
and we're just like,
well,
how are we going to shoot these guys? You can't shoot a gun at them.
Yeah. They're made out of fucking energy or something like that.
Yeah.
Right? Well, that's what all the scary movies are about. Like, a bad guy is like made out of electricity or like something that you can't battle unless a superhero comes by, you know? Does that make sense?
What if, dude, what if the electricity that we use on Earth is actually an alien species?
Dude, that is...
And we're just using them to, like, fucking power light bulbs and, like...
Oh, my God.
This is crazy, man.
That's the craziest theory we've had on this show so far.
I think if there's any writers, like, we should write, like, a novelization of my theory of electricity being captured by the great Benjamin Franklin. He pulled them out of the fucking sky. He pulled them out of the sky. They were going down to visit him, like, hello, Earth. And he used his fucking kite, and he anchored them down, and he started stealing their souls.
So, like, energy doesn't come from the sun or anything?
No,
like that.
It comes from it's an alien species that came down peacefully.
Peacefully?
Yeah, they were watching us, like, throughout the civilization, like, oh, they've started fire.
How could you show electricity peacefully? It's, like, such a violent thing. Like, I'm trying to imagine an alien energy source rays coming down and being peaceful, and it's just, they'd be all crackling and stuff like that. You'd be like, whoa, dude. Back off. They're like, no, we're peaceful.
How could you fight electricity, man? You can't fight it. We would just turn it off.
You just turn it off?
Yeah.
Directed by M. Night Shyamalan.
Maximum Overdrive. Do you remember that movie?
No.
Dude, Maximum Overdrive. It's the fucking best. It's like a Stephen King movie. And basically what happens is there's an asteroid that is it's closer to the Earth at one certain day. And all of the machines start rising up against the humans. Mm-hmm. Dude, it's fucking awesome. A fucking lawnmower runs over, like, the guy mowing the lawn.
Oh, I think I've seen that.
And their kids are at the Little League practice, and the soda machine starts spitting fucking soda cans out and hitting kids in the head.
So how do they
win it? The semi-trucks trap these people at this truck stop. Fucking Emilio Estevez is in it, and he has to, like, shoot the guys with the bazookas, the trucks.
Yeah, but how do they win against the electricity then? They turn it off? Is it you're saying that, like, at the end, I'm just picturing a janitor, like, oh, you just gotta turn it off.
Oh,
like,
yeah, you press the wrong switch over
like
here.
30 kids are trapped in a school from electricity. Like, soda machines are trying to kill them and shit like that. And the janitor's like, yeah, you just gotta.
Oh, yeah. Just
you flip just a switch.
You're connected to a battery, dumbass. Turn that shit off.
Unplug it.
Yeah,
unplug it. Unplug the evil toaster and all. It's not like
that'd be the only way to fight them, though. You could use
EMT, man.
Dude, what about like static electricity, though? Like, if there was like a. Like a walking thing of lightning coming at you, and he was just like, "Yeah, I'm gonna fight you," and you're like, "Oh, what am I gonna use? Would you use like a?"
We just rub each other, and then
like balloons. What about like fucking you? You're armed with like balloons. Like
you're talking about fighting energy with energy. You're like,
well, maybe use if I power against
static,
you.
Maybe if I rub my hands together real fast, I can battle this electricity monster.
Dude, maybe when you're rubbing your hands together really fast to get feel electricity, you're actually summoning a fucking alien species.
Maybe you're killing an. Every time you rub your hands together,
maybe you're jacking off as electric alien. You're just rubbing your hands together, and you're like, "Oh, he's like, oh, this is great. These fucking humans."
That's what static electricity is. It's jizzing. It's an electricity alien living on your hand, jizzing.
Oh,
out
that's
of your
awesome.
Fingers.
I want to read that book too, dude. That'd be a fun movie to watch.
All right, that's a porno.
Yeah. Yeah.
You want to want electro
porno. It's one of those like sexy sci-fi movies.
Just two fucking energies just fucking...
and then it just zooms out. It's just static going like... That's them jizzing.
That's a pretty good jizz. I'd say your acting skills...
That was a full motion body. I was like...
Is that what you do every time a girl like makes you fucking jizz?
I actually curl up into a little ball first. I go... and I explode with my legs and arms out.
All right, that's gross. Yeah, well, that, I think we should we move on
I
to
I think
user?
We should talk. We're doing the user suggestions right now. You put it about 15, 20 minutes ago?
Yeah, yeah. So let me get the list out here.
We're just going to read them off fast and talk about the things we want to talk about, then fuck off on the things we don't want to talk about.
We thought that was funny last time. We were going to just fucking... I said, we'll talk about anything you
post.
Oh,
dude, it was funny.
Yeah.
It's always so it's been 36. Funny for the last couple ones.
We have 36.
36?
Yeah, dude.
Dude, there's going to be like 40 by the time we're recording this,
we're
sure.
We're going to hit the big time.
This is because it was time. Like when you first checked it a minute ago, it was like 10, 15.
A minute ago? Like, you mean like 40 minutes ago?
I mean
ago?
Like, yeah, like, you know, 40 minutes ago.
All right, here we go. Ready?
All right.
Should I say the name of their thing too, or does that
no,
take up too much time?
No, that's a fucking okay. Shout out. That's like something you just get on like TRL. All
right. How about first person gets their name shouted out and everyone else fuck them? Beth Rippin was number one this week.
Congratulations on being number one. You won a fucking t-shirt.
You are number one? Okay. Worst place you ever put your hand?
My hand?
Give me a real answer. I want like the real answer. Worst place you ever put your hand?
I don't know.
I would say in the oven. I burned my hand.
You burn your hand in the oven?
I have a scar, yeah. You've never like cut your hand? Worst place, like a really a girl with an STD, you put worst place you put your hand? You know,
so many girls,
warts
though.
On your fingers.
So many girls, so many vaginas. So, I can't remember.
All right.
Probably one of them.
Your own ass is probably the worst place. Your hand. I'm just gonna go with.
Oh,
that.
Like wiping my butt and like maybe yeah. It like slips in.
All right, that's it. All right. Number two is getting fired from a place that rhymes with Lenny's.
What rhymes with Lenny's?
Denny's.
Okay. Why would that be relevant?
Because someone never knows that I've been fired from Denny's before.
Okay.
Let me paint you a quick story. It was on Christmas Day. My friend came in to order dinner or order breakfast, and I bought him breakfast, but I didn't pay for his orange juice, and the boss saw that and fired me on the spot.
Well, like you were giving out freebies?
Yeah, giving out free orange juice. And
did
I
you do
fired.
It intentionally?
Yeah. I was trying to give a friend of mine free orange juice. And
so like orange juice at Denny's is what, like $7? It's always fucking expensive as shit. It's like $2.40
worth
probably,
being
right?
Fired for though?
Or is orange juice like $2.50?
Yeah, it's like $2.50.
Okay, so that's fucking expensive.
Over. I got fired from Denny's on Christmas Day over a $2.50 orange juice.
Dude, what was the boss's deal? Was he or she just like a total bitch?
Well, I was new. Like I was new to him. I had been working there for a while, but the new manager.
Oh, so he was just clearing house. He just didn't like your face, and he was just
once
like, any excuse I see to fire this fucker.
Exactly. All right. Most blank places to have sex, ex-Canadian or hillbilly? Is that a question? Most blank places.
Oh, what's
to
the
have
most hillbilly place you've had sex?
Ex-Canadian.
Or what's the most what's that most hillbilly place you could have sex? I would say
what you think the question is?
Yeah.
No, I'm too high to understand this question.
Okay, like, what would be the most hillbilly way to like have sex? Would it be like in a Burger King bathroom? That's kind of ghetto though. I would say like maybe like the cab of your truck when you're out hunting. Would be pretty
I think I get like what would have the most places to have sex? I don't know. It doesn't make sense to me. I'm moving on.
Porta potty would be a redneck place to have sex.
I'm moving on, dude. Kittens. Do you want to talk about kittens?
I'm not a fan of cats, and I think people love them more
overrated.
Than they should.
Kittens are overrated.
Overrated.
All right. What if our skin was transparent?
Dude, that'd be fucking weird.
Gross. It would be gross. Or would we be used to it and we would find that hot? Like, oh, that girl has such a nice shaped heart.
Oh, man, look at her. Look at her fucking, kidneys.
Yeah, her kidneys are fucking...
The way she's got those dimples in her kidneys, man, when she bends over.
Oh,
she bent over, I saw her vulva, dude.
Are you a kidney man or are you a liver man?
You know what I think is sexy?
I gotta have a nice kidney.
I think as sexy as fucking neck muscles.
So, yeah, but you think those are sexy whether they have transparent skin or not.
Guess so.
It's weird.
I like my ESPN women's fitness championships.
Right. Dick waffles is the next topic.
Whoa. Would that be like wrapping a waffle around your dick?
Or like two dicks. Or wait a sec.
Dick waffle.
What the fuck is a dick waffle?
What is a dick waffle? Is it okay? Maybe it's a waffle that you put in your cast iron, but you made it in the shape of a dick. I would still eat it.
I'm going to go with...
I like waffles.
I could see that at a fucking country store.
Like if you had like a restaurant where all the shapes of the food was just penises and vaginas and boobs.
Dick, a waffle that's shaped like a dick.
That'd be awesome. Dick waffle.
You would eat a dick waffle?
Can I get an order of dick waffles and a side of fucking egg titties? Yeah.
Dick waffles and
yeah,
egg
you,
titties.
Yeah, you can. Because that'd be the place, dude. You could go there. No one under 17 can go, of course, you know, because it's offensive.
They would put whipped cream on the balls or something.
Can I get
like
that? Can I get an extra extra whipped cream on my dick waffles?
And my egg what is it? Egg titties?
Egg titties.
Okay, why more girls don't make your mom jokes?
I think that's kind of a guy thing.
Why is your dad
it's
not
a guy
big thing?
Yeah, it's never dad jokes. Anything about dad jokes, it's all mom jokes.
Okay. Oh well. My boobs. Oh, I know this girl. I would like to see them.
You never seen them?
I've never seen her boobs.
We make that happen sometime?
Yeah.
She want to be on the show?
I hope she's listening, and if you show me your boobs, that would be a great thing.
I would say boobs are always welcome.
Boobs are always welcome.
But we can't judge them until we see them.
I think I asked her on a date, and she denied me, so that probably won't go well.
Well, maybe there's a chance for me. Maybe you could be my wingman.
All right, let's do it. Let's get you some of these boobs.
All right. Then we can get a firsthand experience, and then maybe like podcast, what is it, like 47, I'll report back to you.
All right. Jeez, you're going to be
married
with
this
kids
and this will be like what we play at the bachelor party. Like, oh, man.
We play Fuckcast 23.
Yeah, that was like the first time I ever mentioned you and her together. Now that you have 17 grandkids and you're the wealthiest man in America.
Whoa. You're scaring her away. You're moving too fast. All right, next topic. Which is better sandwich meat, bologna or roast beef? Bologna's more popular. Roast beef is clearly better in my opinion.
Yeah, roast beef is a little bit more real. I think bologna's kind of like, you know, when it's like fake. It's like a mix. Yeah. It's like hot dog,
but
you know?
It's more
don't really know what it is.
More popular. Are we just grading by taste? Are we grading by like accessibility, price? Like there's so many things that go
like
into
if you were in the wild, you'd obviously have more chance to get roast beef than you would fucking bologna.
Well,
there's not like a bologna tree that drops down little fucking rolls of bologna.
So that's what you're making. I'm saying that we don't have enough information on what we're grading this sandwich meat by. He didn't say taste.
Dude,
or
we never have enough information about what we're talking about anyways.
All right, next topic is haha blue waffles. We talked about waffles?
Oh, yeah, no, not blue waffles.
Don't order a blue waffle.
Do not ever
order some dick waffles.
Don't even, people at home, don't even look up blue waffles. You do not want to see it.
Do not look that up.
Do not look it up.
Next one, folks, that's a technical number, is the NDAA. What does that stand for?
The DDA?
NDAA. I think that's like an association or something.
NDEA. I'm going to have to look it up.
NDAA.
NDAA.
Don't look it up. Fuck it. There's too many topics. Quantum mechanics. They're really mechanical. They're hard to know.
Is that just like regular mechanics, but
quantum? Yeah. That's like
I think quantum sounds like super futuristic. Whenever you say quantum something, it just sounds like.
All right. What's a word that goes with quantum that's not super realistic? Quantum,
like tree formation.
No, that's still futuristic. Like if you say like,
they'd be like to maximize the efficiency of the trees' photosynthesis, we have put them in a quantum arrangement. That sounds fucking cool.
Yeah. Well, like quantum, like a sandwich meat, or like quantum bologna. That
like,
makes it sound
to,
silly.
Yeah, you have to. It has to. No, quantum bologna sounds like scientists in a fucking lab trying to create the perfect bologna shape.
All right, it sounds like
dude, everything
you're pissed off at these.
Quantum anything, dude. Quantum slippers. Like normal slippers, but these are quantum because they fucking.
I picture two kids in school, and you're telling me something, and we're two nerds, and I'm like, dude, that's quantum baloney.
I think anything you say with quantum, I challenge the readers to write in
find something that's
anything
cooler.
That's like quantum wagons, like even
quantum
like
sandals.
Quantum sandals is like fucking high tech shit, like extracted from fibers from a spider and like.
So what's technology that could never get cooler, like quantum pencils or something like that?
You'd that sounds like, pretty cool too, man. I'd probably buy some quantum pencils.
Right. Well,
if Bic released quantum pencils, you know you'd buy a fucking pack.
Okay, so this person's saying talk about dragons, but
we talked about dragons a podcast.
Can I said but.
Please go ahead.
He ended it with a Z. Does that change? Is that like a cartoon character dragons, like double dragons or something like that?
Okay, so the first image, if you were doing word association, you said dragons with a Z. First thing I think of would be like
Dragon Ball Z. Is
no, like a kid wearing like one of those like it's like a bowling shirt, you know, like the ones that are like the resort wear shirts, but with like flames on it.
Oh, you're talking about bro shirts.
Yeah, like or like a eight ball with like blue flames on it. Like, dragons. Okay, yeah, you're not cool. Dragons with a Z kind of reminds dragons me of that.
Well, fuck dragons with a Z.
It's S, dragons. Right. Dragons is okay. Plural for one more than one dragon.
If your canoe gets stuck in a tree without its headlights on, how many pancakes will it take to get to the moon? I'm going to go with...
Seven.
I'm going to go with 32.
Really?
Okay. Yep.
I don't think you need that many.
The Super Bowl blackout.
Super Bowl blackout. Have we ever had a podcast blackout? We're totally self-sufficient, dude. We could have a blackout and live through it. We're fine. Actually, no. We don't have any batteries in the...
I don't know why they call it a blackout, because it was only half of... Like, I thought blackouts are when it gets blacked out. We could clearly see the game could have moved on.
Well, I think a blackout is like a technical... It basically means like if a whole city grid goes down, it just blacks everything out.
Uh-huh.
But yeah, if only half the like site goes off...
If the bulb in your room went out right now, but like the rest of the house was still on, would be like, oh, it's a blackout.
If it was at night...
You'd think you had a blackout in your room?
Yeah, if it's in the day, the power's out. You change your word based on if it's light out or not, because a blackout means that all the lights are out.
We talked about the Super Bowl enough. Your worst experience taking a shit. It doesn't have to take place in a bathroom either. I shit myself in a Cheesecake Factory once, not in the bathroom.
I'm trying to think if I ever,
can you
like...
top that?
I'm trying to think if I ever, like, sharted anything, like, really bad. Not really. I mean, probably just the normal, like, getting to the bathroom and, like, just in time to, like, sit down and,
so
like...
So you shit yourself all you know, over... Oh. So you never shit yourself?
I don't think I've ever shit myself.
Wow, dude.
Because I would say in my pants is probably the least favorite place.
You're not a man in life until you've shit yourself in an embarrassing place at least once. And I'll leave it at that. Drums.
I love drums.
I'm hoping in this podcast when we edit it, they make me like Justin Timberlake. He's like, drums, and then the drums come on.
That'd be cool.
All right.
Can you do that?
I don't know.
I like all kinds of drums. I wish I was good at drumming. I think I have a decent, like, you know, I could probably bang a drum like pretty steady, you know, like I have enough like rhythm
to
everyone
thinks
beat a drum.
Have rhythm. That's when white dancing crimes are committed. Cause
yeah, but
white
like
guys
nobody.
Have rhythm.
Okay, but when you go to sit down, if I'm just walking past a drum set, I'm just gonna go crazy and try to make as much sounds as possible. I'm not actually gonna try to carry a beat. I don't know what the hell I'm doing.
So you're saying you wish you were good at it.
I'm saying I might be good at it. I've just never really tried that hard.
All right. Well, stop complaining.
Do you play the drums?
Nah, I'm not good at it. I don't try that hard.
Bongo drums.
Same
are cool.
Story. I have the same story as you. But I was trying to make fun of you about it.
All right, next topic.
Tattooed vagina, vag.
What would it be a tattoo of? Because
like,
that could change.
Girls put a butterfly around it.
Yeah, if it's like a
garbage disposal.
No, not a butterfly. Oh, not a garbage disposal. Like if it's her ex-husband's
insert
name.
Insert here.
Ex-husband's name.
They should make it look like a coin slot.
If you dated a girl and it said like Vince on her vagina and your name was obviously not Vince, would you be into that or no?
Well, it depends on the situation. Like, am I just trying to bang this chick or am I trying to marry her? You know what I mean? I don't know if I could marry anyone with Vince on their vagina, nor do I hope that I would fall in love with someone, although my current track record says that I probably could find a girl that has a coin slot or a Vince tattooed on her vagina and then like that kind of person. But that's a deal breaker. Guy's name on a vagina if you really like her.
So like a sun, like a rainbow coming over her, like would that be okay?
Probably like a little rainbow jumping over the vagina. Would you be okay with a little rainbow, or would you be like, wow, that is a slutty thing to do?
What if you had like a, I saw one person in like their pubic area get like a little man pushing a lawnmower. Yeah. And like every morning they just have to shave that little part where the lawnmower is, so it looks like you're shaving your bush.
Sure, that would mean she has a great sense of humor, and I'm fucking marrying that girl. All right. Next
plus
topic.
That's fun.
The Necronomicon. The Necronomicon.
I don't know what that is. We can barely say it.
Necronomicon.
Is that like a robot or something?
Sounds like a metal band. That's actually a Necrogoblicon or Gobla.
That sounds like a
Gobla Necrocon or is a band name. So I don't know what a Necronomicon is.
Okay,
so
you've stumped us. Good
job.
Yeah,
you win. Duh. You're so great.
You win like a fuck-ass thong or something.
Okay. The little boy who called 911 to help with his math. Aw, that's cute.
That's sweet. Maybe
did they show up? Bitch, they busted. It's 2+2.
Have you ever thought about what if he was trying to multiply 9 times 11 and accidentally called 911? Because the keypad on the iPhone and the calculator look pretty similar.
It's saying like, hi.
Can you help me? What's 2+2? How old was this kid?
I don't have all the you're asking for more information, but like
if it was like a 5-year-old,
you're saying he by accidentally dialed 911 because he thought his fucking phone was a calculator or something like that.
Yeah.
Instead of calling because he needed help. Because
he knew what 911 was. He just had to call someone.
Yeah, he had to call someone.
He's like, well, the only phone number I have is 911.
He thought it was an emergency. He's like, oh, man, this math's so hard.
You better do this, otherwise you're going to get grounded. And he's like, I don't want to get fucking grounded. I'm just going to call 911. That's an emergency. That's an emergency in my life. I don't have a tree burning down or anything in my yard. But
it sounded cute, but what if it was a real emergency? Like, he called and he's like, my dad beats me if I don't finish my homework.
I just got a fucking another awesome idea.
What's that?
Kids 911. You have, like, kids answer the phone and, like, give, like, legitimate questions to, like, their problems. They're like, this girl at school doesn't like me, 911. What should I do? And they're like, well, have you, like, tried talking to her? She's like, well, I have a class with her. I'm like, well, maybe next time, you know, just.
You're trying to get like, a kindergarten late?
Well, like, if kids were able to just, like, call a phone number for their problems and it was, like, an actual dispatcher.
Yeah, but you went straight with trying to get a kid laid rather than, like, what?
I'm trying to get him to, like, his first kiss, not get him laid. This is, like, fucking three-year-old calling it. Jesus Christ.
I don't know. It'd be more like.
I'm not trying to get three-year-olds laid.
What crayon color should I use? Not how do I hook up with this fucking nice
like, if there was
thing.
A bully. Okay, so, like, this kid's, like, in the fucking forest and he's got a cell phone. He's like, I was fucking playing fucking wizards out in the forest and these bullies are after me. Quick, send someone. And like a kid comes by on his Hot Wheels, like, all right, pull over.
Woo, woo. You have to do it with his fucking voice or something like that. All right.
Little kids.
Next
I
one.
Like
is
I like it.
Smelly vagina.
Ooh, no. Clean it up. Excuse yourself. Go to the bathroom. Splash some water on it.
That would help it. What if it's like rank? My friend used the word today, ferocious. Like if the smell was ferocious, you couldn't even wash it off.
So. Like, maybe, like, after, like, a gym session, like, a hot gym session.
What
like
if she's just, like, that's her natural smell.
Oh, what if it's like your first date and she's like, oh, I've been wanting to have sex with you all night. And you're just like, all right, well, she probably, like, took care of it. And you're like, whoa. It's, like, the first time she knew we were going to have sex tonight and she didn't.
So she cleaned that shit up real nice. And it's
still.
Yeah,
she's like, I cleaned it up for you. And you're like, no, you didn't.
Well, and then you would have to, what do you do?
Would it be
you
a deal?
Walk away.
At what point would it be a deal breaker?
Walk away from ferocious vagina, always.
Because if it's like, okay, always. So if I was walking through the mall in Scottsdale and Jessica Alba was there and I was like, oh my God. Like
pre-baby.
We're both at the, pre-baby. We should clarify, pre-baby.
Pre-baby Jessica Alba.
And she was like, she was going on with her life. She was enjoying, being an actress and stuff like that. She's still pretty young in her actress life. And we both were, like, buying a pretzel at the same time. We struck up a conversation, and we ended up, like, having sex that night. What if she just didn't know anything that she wasn't expecting it at all? She just had, kind of an unkempt area.
Evan, I know this would be hard for you because you would be so ecstatic. You're like, I'm going to smash this fucking pre-baby Jessica
Alba. I would be happy. I wouldn't be like, well, her vagina kind of smells bad.
No,
like, if it's Jessica
away.
Alba pre-baby, I'm going for it.
And her vagina smells ferocious.
I'm going bad. I'm going for it.
You get out of there.
Oh, you think that your advice would be to fucking dump her high and dry?
No. It depends on, not for Jessica Alba, not for me, but you know that story, so.
Yeah.
Like, she's not my number one, but if it was my number one and she had a ferocious vagina, I'd be like, just
who's your number one?
Power through it.
Have we ever talked about this? Your number one.
I don't have like a number one.
Give me one out of your top three. Is it like, Katy Perry on your list?
No, like Scarlett Johansson.
Okay. So if you met Scarlett Johansson in an elevator and she was like,
ferocious vagina.
Do me. And you're like, all right. And you pull down her pants and it was just like, Scarlett.
You got to power through it. You got to put on that mask and just fucking
get the weed whacker out.
Get to work. All right. The first time.
Is there more?
Yeah, dude. We're still going.
Keep going.
The first time you stayed at a motor, and then ran out of toilet paper. Then you had to do a shit man shuffle to get the Bible out of the top drawer next to the bed and use a few pages. Then the toilet didn't flush and you didn't get your deposit back because Gus, who looked like sex offender at the front desk, was a fucking born again or some shit. All right, new rule. If it's longer than a sentence or two, then we're going to let it go.
It's a topic, people. Don't interject your stories on here.
Sex talk, sex. Done enough?
We talk about sex on every single episode.
Do they want like sexy like phone operators?
Oh, you want like a sexy deep voice?
You want us to like make your wildest dreams audibly come true?
My name's Chaz. I'm a firefighter. I just got back from fighting a fire and getting a kitten out of a tree.
And then I went to the gym.
Call now.
Then I stopped at the gym on the way home.
Oh, yeah.
Just did 375,000 pounds.
Me and the guys were waiting at the fire station, had a sit-up competition, and I won. I did 1,500 push-ups. Call now. It's only $1.99 a minute.
The Fuckcast.
Fuckcast. We should do that. We should start another alter ego and have like heavy metal music and be like, hey, it's back to the Fuckcast with Chaz and
all right, we'll get it started. We need alter egos. Swamp monsters. Only swamp monsters?
Swamp monsters could be anything. Could it be an alligator? Could an alligator be a swamp monster?
No, it's not a monster. I think it means like the swamp thing or something.
Oh,
like that.
Like an actual person. Yeah. Like
I don't. But I don't. He's not asking a question. He's just
like Swamp Man, old movies.
Talk about swamp monsters. All right.
I think swamp monsters could be anything. You know, it could be a an alligator out there. Could be a angry bird or something that could attack you. Like that's a swamp monster.
Could be close to a human being that just runs around and fucks hot bitches. That's what Swamp Thing's about, right?
What about like redneck hillbillies that are like super, super inbred out there?
You consider that a swamp monster? Like you met a girl and you're like, she's fucking Swamp Thing looking, you know what I mean? But she's like someone's sister out there or something like that?
Yeah, she's like, oh, I want you to meet my dad. And like you go out to like the fucking Everglades on a fucking, what's it called? What's the thing called? The
airboat or something?
Airboat, yeah.
And you meet Swamp Thing.
And they're like an inbred backwoods, like,
yeah.
That'd be like a swamp monster.
I get into that.
Okay.
Hentai.
Do you
get into that?
Is anime porn,
like,
right?
Like octopuses raping like schoolgirls, basically.
Well, that's because they can't show male genitalia, right? They can't show dicks, so they have to make it like a fucking tentacles.
Really? And so they really get off on that?
So like if they put like a couple extra like tubes coming out of like an alien or something like that, they can make it look like a dick, but they
when
can't actually show
dick?
Like a.
Wow, is that the origin of why hentai exists?
I think so.
Oh, I thought it was just because they were sick as fuck.
Oh, I think that too. I think they have, they've surpassed this technology-wise, and they're getting like, you know, they get bored of just regular things, so they have to come up with machines fucking them.
They're getting freaky. All right. The photographer as porn, one of the biggest German photographers will do this. I can't open links. Fuck you. Ass to mouth.
Don't send us links, guys. This is a topic. Give us
links.
A topic.
Ass to mouth, ATM. Do you ever call a girl ATM? You know a girl's super hot when a guy's like, that shit's ATM. Like, he would lick her ass. Call it next time you see a girl, you know how you do your ones and zeros at work, just say that girl's ATM. That's what me and my friends used to do.
All right, I'm gonna start saying that at work, and the guys are like, what the fuck are you talking about?
Tell
like,
them. Then it means ass to mouth. She's so fucking hot, I would eat her ass.
Jessica Alba pre-baby
is ATM.
Yeah.
All right. Why this one's too long, I'm skipping. Worst place you had sex. Well, I don't want to say the worst story because we've done that before, but worst place, like
just give me a place.
Like, I think in a car, like, thought it would be awesome, but, like, it was just too cramped. Just, I've had sex in a church parking lot, though. That was pretty nice.
Yeah.
You.
I'd say my worst place is, like, it was, like, one of those house parties where everyone was, like, passed out, like, the living room. And I was, like, sleeping next to this girl, and we had sex, like, with, like, six people sleeping around us.
Really? How'd that go? Was bad?
It was all right. We were, like, under a blanket the whole time, but, like, it was.
Worst. Oh, you mean dangerous-wise?
I don't know. I would say that was like, it was kind of like hairy. I don't know. It was kind of cool,
I
guess.
It's worse, like the one you didn't enjoy. So would that be it still?
I didn't enjoy it because I was like super nervous the whole time that someone was going to fucking wake up. And
all right. This one is the size of your penis. I don't want to freak you out, ladies, but it's average. I don't have like crazy black jeans or anything like that.
Yeah.
Like,
when's the last time you've measured? Have you ever stuck? I mean, I think every single guy has stuck a ruler up underneath their dick, but
a year ago. Jacking off, just bored, like, oh, there's a fucking, let's measure my penis.
Let's check the circumference.
Oh, let's see what's going on. All right. Next one. Smashing cake all over your partner during cake or having sex on cake.
I think that'd be fun.
Yeah.
Keep it interesting, you know? Like 6 months, you're like, I've been going out with this girl for a long time. We pretty much have sex in the same, you know, general positions. We're going to mix it up today. It's fucking 6 month anniversary. Let's add some cake to the mix.
Would you just rub cake on her? Or would you like have sex on a cake?
Like I don't know, man.
Big cake from Walmart.
I think here's how I would do it. I would first, so we don't worry about anything. I'd be like, honey, I want you to come down to the garage. She comes down to the garage and like everything's like fucking like tarped down. So like the car is not going to get fucking frosting on it. So like that's not a worry of hers. It's like, I'm going to have to clean the car. I got to work tomorrow morning. It's like everything's fucking like, wrapped up, taken care of. It's a fucking slippery surface, and there's a big fucking cake in the middle. And I would like take it and like bring it over there and like have her like lick it off my finger and stuff. And then you like slowly get into it. And then like maybe you get to like a fun thing where you like you take a big handful and like slap her across the face with it or something like that.
And shove it in her mouth.
And you get to the point where there's just fucking cake flying around everywhere.
And fucking.
And then you just fucking.
And it's wonderful.
And it's awesome.
I'm into that.
And then all you do tomorrow for cleanup is just, you know, get the tarp and just rattle it up in a big bowl and put in the fucking. If it's Thursday, it'd be even better.
What keeps it dirty
is trash day.
What keeps it dirty and interesting is not trying to keep it sanitary. It's letting the house get all dirty. Like if you,
dude,
if you
you're saying that you
want to
have couch like cake sex in like the fucking living room.
That's what makes it hot.
Like, so you're gonna have to go the next
day. If you go all Dexter on the cake situation and you cover everything in plastic, that makes.
So you're saying you want to go to like spend the whole rest of the next day like renting a fucking shampoo carpet cleaner?
Yeah.
And like fixing everything.
That's what I'm gonna do for my woman.
God damn, man. I mean, I guess if it's spontaneous, you're like, hey, it's your birthday today, and she's like, oh. I've never had sex with cake before. And you're like, all right, let's fucking do this. And then you just let
occasion.
It go.
Special occasion.
Yeah, if it just happens spontaneously, but like if you make a big deal about it, I'd say, you know.
Okay, well, the next one is pierced vaginas.
I'm down with that. Depends on how pierced, though. If it's gauged.
Whoa, dude. Let's not. A gauged vagina would be like ferocious, smelly pussy. You don't want. And when if they're both, then it doesn't matter if she's Jessica Alba with pre-baby. Pierced,
dude. If Jessica Alba pre-baby had like a pierced with a gauged vagina lips, I would not be down for that.
This one kind of just answered the most horrid sex experience. We just kind of
It'd be like looking at the predator's face.
And then someone said tentacle rape as a tattoo theme. Who you would sell Satan for a corn chip, and what you do if you encountered a panda guru? I don't want to.
Good lord, just pick one.
Yeah, this one's
save
long
him
too.
For next time.
And the last one is there's another long one, so I'm skipping it. The last one is the advantages and disadvantages of two genital piercings. Jesus Christ, people!
What if you both had genital piercings and they got like stuck when you were doing it,
and then they ripped?
Ooh!
On your genitals? Just don't. Why do you got to get piercings on your genitals?
Yeah,
like I guess some people like that. Like as far as a turn.
I guess there could be. I guess you know if. It Stay adds away. To sensitivity or something like that, you know?
But does it for guys? Like, if you get... Some guys get their fucking genitals pierced. Like.
Well, girls that get their tongue pierced, like, that helps with, like, fellatio.
I've never experienced it. Have you?
At one time, and it was like... It was like a quick, like, not good blowjob, because it was like... It was like a half blowjob just to, like, get like, sex.
So you don't know if it was better or not?
It wasn't like she, like, made a big production about it. It was like, hey... Oh. I'm going to do this for a little bit, and then we're going to have
sex.
Could
you tell or not?
I could tell that it was there, but it was like the solid metal rounded ones.
So you're saying not it didn't
I would have liked to explore the subject more. I don't think I have enough to make a hypothesis.
You need a bigger test group? Well, we almost made you a love connection tonight with the girl with the
she have a tongue
boobs. Right? I don't know. We'll talk about this after.
First date, I'll report back.
Let me know.
Is that the end of the user suggestions?
That's the end of the user
suggestions. Because I would have to say those are pretty good user suggestions. With the exception of a few fucking knucklehead pranksters trying to send us fucking links to open. You think we can figure that shit out while we're kind of in our state that we're in?
You better call 911 because we're going to fucking beat
I'm going to call Kids 911.
Kids 911. You better get Kid 911 on the Fuckcast.
Yeah,
dude.
You're
about to fucking...
Fucking bullying us.
Yeah. Stop doing that.
Bullying's
Send
not
us
cool.
some nice topics.
My teacher showed me his pee-pee. 911, what should I do?
What the fuck? All right. You just went real pedophile on us real quick.
All right, guys. Well, we did three topics. That's fine.
We're just
cool
gonna,
with that.
We're going to end that there, and I think it was a good time. Hopefully you enjoyed it.
Good we'll job. Thanks for the participation. Yeah. That was always fun. I felt like you guys were all here.
Yeah. You were here with us, and now we're done.
It's great. Right? Okay.
See you later.
See you next time. Bye. The reason that I had to believe you weren't you understand. Try out and save yourself. Take all, take stuff. It used to be the reason I breathe, but now it's choking me up. Try out and save yourself. Seem quite fair. Despite everything he learned from his friends, he doesn't feel so prepared. She's breathing quiet and smooth. He is gasping for air. This is the first and last time he says. She fakes a smile and presses her hips into his. He keeps his hands pinned down at his side. He's holding back from telling her exactly what it really feels like. He is a lamb, she is the slaughter. She's moving way too fast, and all he wanted was to hold her. Nothing that he tells is really having an effect. He whispers that he loves her, but she's probably only looking for so much more than he could ever give. A life full of lies and a meaningful relationship. He keeps his hands pinned down at his side. He waits for it to end and for the aching in his gut.